All right, there was a Q&A with LeBron James yesterday, and the person asking the question works for Cleveland.com, an NBA writer. His name is Joe Vardon. Let me play that exchange with LeBron, and then we'll talk to Joe about what LeBron said or didn't say.
LeBron, you may not like this one, and I'm not thrilled asking it. I'm obviously trying to diffuse this a little bit, but it appears that you unfollowed the Cavs on Twitter today, and it's caused quite a stir. Why did you do that, or what would go into that?
Next question.
Next question.
You've had 38 assists tonight. That's a season high. Is this something you can take forward to the next game?
I'm done.
All right, bring in Joe Vardon, Cleveland.com NBA writer. Joe, good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, good morning. I thought I was here to talk about the bathroom.
You know what? Next question. We're going to go LeBron. All right, when you ask that question to LeBron, why did you ask that question to LeBron?
Well, thanks, Dan. The reason is this. I mean, he has, as you said, he has nearly 29 million followers. That is larger than the reach of the NBA Finals in terms of viewership. And he runs his Twitter account. So what he does, what he says on there is important. It is a window into this man and how he's thinking. And, you know, let's be honest, he is the most important sports figure in Cleveland, probably in the history of the city. And it's an extension of him. And unfollowing his own team is trivial, maybe, but it was just strange behavior to the point where it demanded some kind of question and response.
How intimidating is he to the local media?
I don't find him that way. I mean, obviously, you know, you've got that clip there and you've got me, you know, genuflecting and diffusing and stumbling and all of those things. But it was because I knew all of the pitfalls involved with the question. I mean, he is good for me to work with anyway. And certainly with some of my colleagues, that follow the team on a daily basis, as I do. So he's not a bad guy to work with, but this one was just, it was going to be a little bit different, because of the nature of the question.
But why didn't he answer the question, Joe? He could have diffused some of this. He's now made it a story.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know what? I mean, that's actually sort of one of the holes in the eventual answer that we got from that I got from somebody close to him, is he could have just said the answer himself. But he's like, listen, I mean, he's been in the spotlight since he was 14 or 15 years old. He almost never makes mistakes, and he certainly never makes the kind of mistake that ends up in jail or costing him lots of money. But he is human, and there's been a couple of times this year where we've actually talked not about something that I was involved with, that he was really frustrated about, and frustrated about certain kinds of questions that he was getting, just because of all he has done, you know, as a man and as a guy. He doesn't feel he gets the respect for that. And so here he is in the heat of the moment. He had a bad day overall yesterday, which I can get into, but he wasn't having a good day. He knows this question is coming, but he was caught in a moment where he didn't have on his political hat, and he just froze.
Why was he having a bad day yesterday?
Well, I don't know. I don't know what the cause of it was, but here's the thing. You guys know how NBA media schedules work. He talks at shoot-arounds. That's when he talks. He's never missed one in 2 years since he came back to Cleveland. Yesterday, for the first time, again, since he came back, he just didn't talk. And yesterday before the game in the locker room, like, teammates were trying to talk to him, and he just wasn't having it. I tried to talk to him, and it wasn't like he was mean about it, but he clearly wasn't having it. And this is just not him. Like, none of those things are like him. And then you add into it that he unfollows the team on Twitter. And again, you could say it's trivial, but you look at all these behaviors and it's just not like him. So something, something was off. And then, of course, he goes out and plays his best game of the season. So, you know, go figure. But he was having, something was wrong yesterday personally.